So let's try this. Let's make a global variable called sagas that will store an array for us. And we'll use this array for storage of saga functions. Then, all we would need in order to have permanent access to each of these saga functions is to push them into that global array. At that point, we could choose to access these functions even outside the scope they were defined within. The invocation of those saga functions could actually happen after the new saga function that created them was done running. So let's try moving these lines of code down here in between the two calls to new saga, just to see how it would work. Let's try running this code with our simulated interpreter again. So this first line of code will create an array and put it in a global variable called sagas. And this will be where we store each of the saga functions eventually. Then the line that assigns a new value to the hero variable will run and create some random string, in this case boy, to store into the hero variable. New saga is yet another assignment, so a function object gets placed into the new saga variable, and we're ready to do a lookup of new saga, find this function object, and invoke it because of those two parens. Invoking any function creates a new context, and that context is where all the lookups will start. So first we add another variable to that context, foil. Foil is randomly selected to be rat, and here's the interesting part. The sagas array is now stored in a global variable, which means calls to .push should have a lasting effect on it that persists even after new saga has finished running. What do you think is going to be added into this sagas array as a result of this line?